rhino kept on moving back, and elephant thought, oh goodness, this guy's going to charge at me. And then of course, as the rhino kept on moving back, wanting to see the elephant, because elephant literally charged at the rhino and bam, knocked the rhino down onto the ground. And of course, rhino had this huge two holes on his chest and started bleeding, fell to the ground. And of course, the best friend elephant left him there bleeding to death and went and drank the rest of the water and then left. And then of course, as the sun was just touching the horizon, beautiful African sunset, of course, beautiful and gold, a porcupine came looking for the water, and porcupines walk exactly like a white rhino, head down as well. And then of course, porcupine started smelling a little bit of blood and got a bit nervous and bumped onto a rhino, and then right away erected his quills, which then rhino felt pins and needles onto his skin because he was just passing out now and then. He was like, oh man, who is that? And the porcupine went like, well, that's me, you know, the small porcupine. What can I do for you? And rhino said, oh man, porcupine, please, man, can I borrow one of your quills, man? I need to sew these wounds that I've got. And porcupine just went crazy because he needed the quills to protect himself from a leopard and lions and hyenas that are hunting at night. And said, I'm sorry, I cannot do that. And rhino pleaded and said, please, man, I promise I will give it back as you gave it to me. And porcupine went, well, whatever. Boop! Pulled one of the quills, of course, gave it to the rhino, and rhino started sewing the first wound, but he was super tired and falling asleep here and then. And he thought, right, what do I do with this quill?